Hello dear learners, I welcome you all to the today's video lecture on MCQs from pharmaceutical chemistry. Today we are going to talk about the chapter that is cardiovascular drugs. Now coming towards the first question from cardiovascular drugs is, cardiovascular drugs are used in which of these conditions? Whether they are used in treatment of hypertension? Yes, it is possible. Hypertension is increase in blood pressure. Then angina pectoris. Yes, again it is possible because it's again chest pain radiating from the left arm. Then congestive heart failure. Actually, it is HF, congestive heart failure. So all these conditions can be treated by cardiovascular drug. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, cardiotonic drugs have which of the following effects? Either they have positive inotropic effect without increasing the oxygen consumption, either they have positive chronotropic effect without increasing the oxygen consumption, third is positive inotropic effect. Yes, they have positive inotropic effect. That means it can also be called as negative chronotropic or positive inotropic, but it deals with again oxygen consumption also. Positive inotropic effect is observed with increase in oxygen consumption. So this decreased oxygen consumption option is there in the fourth option. So it is not the possible answer. But negative chronotropic and positive inotropic means one and the same. So the correct answer is it is first, it is having positive inotropic effect as well as it works by without increasing the oxygen consumption. Next question is, cardiotonic drugs are used in dash. Whether they are used in atrial flutter, means it's a condition where the heart rhythm, it deals with the heart rhythm disorders. If we are in atria, since the name atrial, atria will beat too quickly. Then atrial fibrillation. Atrial fibrillation deals with the irregular and rapid heart rate. So again, cardiotonic can work on it. Then congestive heart failure. Yes, cardiotonics can work on it. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, it is species of digitalis are. Now this digitalis, from theory point of view also, this is really very, very important. The species, the glycosides part, the hydrolysis of digitalis, all these points are really very important. So we are going to cover it that point of way. Now species of digitalis are, there are two species basically, digitalis purpura and digitalis lanata. So the correct answer is it is C, both of them. Digitalis purpura and digitalis lanata, both are the species of digitalis. Then these species of digitalis, this digitalis purpura and digitalis lanata, both the species, they contains which glycosides? So digitalis purpura contains two glycosides, that is digitoxin and gitoxin, and digitalis lanata contains digitoxin, gitoxin and digoxin, all the three glycosides. Lanata contains three glycosides and purpura contains two glycosides. So what are they? Digitalis lanata contains dash glycosides. Digitoxin, yes, it contains digitoxin. Gitoxin, it also contains gitoxin. Digoxin also contains, it also contains digoxin. So the correct answer is it is all of them. Next question is, now purpura. Purpura, as we just now discussed, that it contains both digitoxin as well as gitoxin. So the correct answer is A, digitoxin and gitoxin. Synthesis of digitoxin in both the species need which of these? Whether it is purpura glycoside and lanatoside A, digitoxin synthesis. Digitoxin is the very first glycoside which is produced. Digitoxin is the very first product which is produced. So digitoxin needs what precursor? So they need purpura glycoside and lanatoside A, means both the species we will consider here. We will consider digitalis purpura also and digitalis lanata also. So in case of digitoxin, in case of digitalis purpura, it needs precursor as a purpura glycoside A, and in case of digitalis lanata, it needs lanatocyte precursor, lanatocyte A as a precursor, since it's a very first product which is formed. So the correct answer is it is purpura glycoside A and lanatocyte A. Next question is, synthesis of gitoxin in both the species need. Now digitoxin and gitoxin is very common to both the species of purpura as well as lanata. Only digoxin is additional in case of lanata. So gitoxin, again we will study it in the same way we have seen for digoxin. So it needs purpura glycoside B and lanatocyte B. Why B? Because it is on the second place and digitoxin is on the first place. So both will need AA, and here gitoxin, since it is on the second place, both will need BB, purpura glycoside B and lanatocyte B. Next question is, on hydrolysis, cardiac glycosides give. Just now we discussed that cardiac glycosides on hydrolysis gives a glycan and sugar. So it is, the correct answer is it is A, that is a glycan and sugar. Next question is, a glycan from cardiac glycoside is responsible for what? A glycan confers whether cardiotonic property, urinary activity, liver activity or muscle activity. So since it is to be deal with the heart, so the correct answer is it is cardiotonic activity. Then a glycan moiety is produced and sugar molecules are produced, right? So glycan from cardiac glycoside is responsible for what? Means sugar moiety is responsible for solubility and distribution of drug. The sugar molecules which are produced will confer pharmacokinetic properties. Then next question is, digitalis lanata contains dash a glycan parts. Lanata contains three a glycan parts. Since it is digitoxygenin, gitoxygenin and digoxygenin, so it is, correct answer is it is all of them. Digitoxin will give digitoxygenin, gitoxin will give gitoxygenin, digoxin will give digoxygenin. Next question is, which of the given is a beta blocker? Diltiazem, verapamil, nicorandil or propranolol? Diltiazem, verapamil or all calcium channel blockers. The correct answer is it is propranolol, atenolol, metoprolol, all lols are beta blockers. The next question is, which of the given is a calcium channel blocker? The trick to remember calcium channel blocker is Nivedita. So this trick in detail you will get in the video of trick to remember the classification of cardiovascular drugs. So this the link of the same video, I am sharing it in the description box. So first I will suggest you to go through it. It is really very interesting classification of whole cardiovascular drugs, starting from hypertensive drugs, then anti-anginal drugs, all the drugs are included in this. So the correct answer is calcium channel blocker, or amongst these is diltiazem. Then next question is, glyceryl trinitrate is, whether it's a aspirin, whether it's a nitroglycerin, whether it is nicorandil or propranolol. So the correct answer is it is nitroglycerin, is also known as glyceryl trinitrate. Next question is, which of the given is a ACE inhibitor? Whether it is captopril, aspirin, nicorandil or propranolol. Now all prils generally are ACE inhibitors, such as captopril, enalapril, lisinopril, etc. Next question is, anti-hyperlipidemic drugs are also known as dash. Anti to hyperlipidemia. Hyperlipidemia means increased levels of lipids, and anti to it means to lower down the lipids. So they are also known as lipid lowering agents. Yes, because they are supposed to lower the lipids. Then hypolipidemic, that means they will again lower the lipids. So both the terms are one and the same. So the correct answer is it is both of them. Next question is, which of the given is a fibrate? Whether aspirin, nicorandil, propranolol or clofibrate. So it is very much clear that clofibrate, since it contains fibrate, so it is, R should be there here first and then A. So it is very much clear from the suffix that fibrate is clofibrate. Then quinidine is the alkaloid which is obtained from, whether it is obtained from cinchona bark, arjuna bark, cinnamon bark or none of them. The correct answer is quinidine is obtained from cinchona bark. Next question is, digitalis is a dash, whether it is a cardiotonic, parasympathetic, sympathetic or antihypertensive. Since digitalis is working on the heart, it is cardiotonic. Then next question is, anti-anginal drugs amongst these is what? Whether it is glyceryl trinitrate, digitalis, clofibrate or menadione. The correct answer is glyceryl trinitrate, which is classified under anti-anginal drug. And the detailed trick is given in the link, which I have shared in the description box. Then antihypertensive drugs means what? Anti to hypertension. Hypertension is increased BP. And anti to increased BP is to lower the BP. So the options are reduce the increased BP. Yes, it is possible. Inhibit the increased BP. No, it is not possible. Inhibiting the BP is not an actual proper term. Then increase the BP. No, it is not possible. Increase heart systole. It is also correct answer. So it is reduces the increased BP. Antihypertensive mechanism is to reduce the increased blood pressure. Next question is, reserpine contains which heterocycle? Reserpine, whether it contains indole heterocycle, xanthine heterocycle, acridine heterocycle or quinoline heterocycle. According to the structure, the reserpine contains indole heterocycle. Next question is, brand name of propranolol is, whether it is Cipla, Inderal, Atenolol, Aten. Atenolol, Aten is not possible. It's a beta blocker, Betaloc, Metale, again it's a beta blocker. This Viramil, Vazopran, again it's a calcium channel blocker. So the correct answer is it is Cipla and Inderal. Next question is, the brand name of Atenolol is, the correct answer is Atenol and Aten, since it resembles the name, and others are calcium as well as beta blockers. Then next question is, antihypertensive drugs amongst these are what? Diazepam, no. Cotrimoxazole, no. Zinc oxide also, it is not an antihypertensive drug. So the correct answer is it is prazosin. The next question is, which drug decreases the release of catecholamines in CVS? The options are guanethidine, clofibrate, nifedipine, verapamil. The correct answer is it is guanethidine. Next question is, which drug used to decrease the cholesterol LDL and increase the level of HDL in blood? All these are supposed to deal with the lipids. So it is definitely an anti-hyperlipidemic. HDL, LDL are the forms of low density lipoprotein, high density lipoprotein. So correct answer is it is anti-hyperlipidemic, means to deal with the decrease the lipids. Quinidine contains which heterocycle? Quinidine, whether it is quinoline, xanthine, acridine or pyridine. So from the name, it is very much clear that quinidine contains quinoline as a heterocycle. With this, we finish with few of the possible MCQs on cardiovascular system. Thank you.